All right. Welcome to another episode of The Prognosticators, where we take you everywhere in the football universe. Guys, it is week 15.
Wow.
Yeah, we're all growed up.
Ready to
move on. More gray hairs.
Couple more from some losses, couple more for some stressful wins. But that's how it goes. Speaking of wins, week 14, probably the most exciting week of this exciting season.
Wow, fellas, what a week.
I'm hyped up. Can you tell? I'm ready, guys. I'm ready to hit.
Friday's ready to go. He's got the pads on. And look, the teams that put the pads on in week 14 and won, well, you get a well-deserved pat on the back. But for the teams that lost, this is for you.
That's right, Minnesota Vikings. Even though you lost, you found a scapegoat to pay for the sins of your $84 million quarterback, and that OC is out of town. Bye.
Ain't that something? Jacksonville, even though you lost, you are a quarterback away from being back in the big show, all right? A year, maybe two.
Okay.
Cincinnati Bengals, even though you lost, hey, man, time for a new quarterback maybe, new coach, new receiver, new running back, new defense.
New uniforms.
Yeah, probably that too.
Yeah. Come on, guys.
It comes up.
Cleats.
It comes up. Oh, the whole gamut. Atlanta Falcons, even though you lost, now you really know that that Super Bowl choke job wasn't a fluke.
Yeah, that's kind of your personality. LA Rams, even though you lost, we got to see what might be a weakness of yours, and I think it's that California quarterback on the frozen tundra. So you better hope that the playoffs run through LA. Because it ain't looking good if it's anywhere under 20 degrees.
Yeah, that's true. Carolina, even though you lost, I hung a lot on you guys this year. You're kind of letting me down right now. But I think the rest of the division is kind of getting wonky, so hang in there.
Yeah, no other choice.
Guess so. Baltimore Ravens, even though you lost, man, you hung with a pretty good team there. Went to overtime and showed you have a young stud at quarterback. Looks like Flacco's on the shelf, maybe for good.
Yeah. So. Looks like it is for good.
Yeah, time for him to join Blake Bortles and just collecting that money.
That's right. Right.
Arizona Cardinals, even though you lost to a really good team. I mean, the Lions beat the Patriots. Remember that? So they must be really good. So you can hang your hat on that.
Hey, Tampa Bay, see also what I just said about Carolina.
Yeah, just rewind the tape. It's right there for you.
Shoot, Buffalo Bills, even though you lost, it was to my New York Jets. So congrats and thank you. And if you need any players, safety or receiver, hit me up.
Ryan Jones.
He's ready. Boy.
He's ready to play.
You guys need some time.
He'll put a hat on.
New England Patriots, even though you lost, well, I knew you were going to lose last week. Didn't think you were going to lose in miracle fashion, but something needs to balance out all the evil spirits you've invoked to win those championships.
Yeah, the dude abides, and maybe there's some divine intervention there. Philadelphia Eagles, even though you lost, you played a tough game on the road, divisional opponent. Any other cliche you want to insert there just to make yourselves feel better for having such a lousy post-Super Bowl season?
Wow.
Fluke.
Hey, Pittsburgh Steelers, even though you lost, let's not get comfortable with this discourse. It's too late in the season to be losing games like this.
3 weeks in a row.
Right. Denver Broncos, even though you lost.
Ha-ha!
Well, if you need a receiver, I'm here. No, and you guys are still have a playoff shot, so hey, tough game coming up. So see what happens.
We'll see what happens. All right, Washington team from Washington, even though you lost, you got Josh Johnson as your quarterback. Hey. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that one album he came out with.
Is that Jack?
I
think that's Chad.
Chad?
I don't know.
Let's just hope this one doesn't skip. And Houston Texans, even though you lost, you can't win them all. 10-game winning streak. Congratulations, you're still on top of the division. And a lot of us think you might take it to the Super Bowl.
Why not?
Yeah, it's going to happen. We'll see you right after this.
Folks, there's no other way but to be all in. Either he's Lord of all or he is not Lord at all. And you can experience the real and authentic, true life change that only God can provide to humanity. See, when we truly encounter Jesus and purpose to know him and follow his teachings, hashtag life change will occur.
Welcome back to the Prognosticators. We are currently looking at the playoff picture for the AFC and the NFC because it's week 15 now, three games left, fellas. All these games are very, very important. We're looking at the seeding going on. Let's start off with the AFC. We got the Kansas City Chiefs up first. They play tonight. They play the Los Angeles Chargers, who are seeded fifth, the first wild card spot. We'll see what happens. The New England Patriots are coming in at number two. Number three, the Houston Texans. Number four, the Pittsburgh Steelers with the tiniest bit of space over the Baltimore Ravens, who are surging. So, fellas, how do you see the playoff picture turning out? And don't forget, in the AFC, you got the Titans, you got the Colts, you got the Browns, and you got the Dolphins on the heels for that final wild card spot. Because it looks like, to me, that Los Angeles Chargers is going to wrap up the fifth seed.
Yeah, the Chargers, I think, are definitely, they might be the second best team in the AFC. Not just the AFC West.
Yeah.
So I think one of those wild cards is for sure theirs. When I just look at the last three games that are coming up, Pittsburgh has a pretty tough schedule. They got the Patriots this Sunday, and they're also facing the Saints on the road. So I see them falling out completely with Baltimore taking the AFC North. And looking at strength of schedule, again, I see the Colts sneaking into that sixth spot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely something that can work. Matt, Friday?
I'm gonna jump right in with the Rook. I think he's on point. And if I were Steeler Nation, I'd feel like a glass house right now.
Mm-hmm. By the way, thank you.
Did you want me to hold on to this?
No, I can hold on to it.
Also in the AFC, I love what Casey's doing, but I just feel like there's people that got them in their crosshairs, like New England and Houston. Mm. And I think those are the real big dogs at this point.
I mean, man, you're right about that. I think the Colts are a team to look out for. You know what I mean? They're playing good ball. Andrew Luck is a vet. You know, he has some experience. And the Texans, they show what they can do against the Texans. So if they get that final wild card spot, you know,
that's
gotta
true.
Look out for them.
The Colts are getting dicey.
The Colts are kind of a team nobody wants to play right now. I know they lost 2 weeks ago, but they came in on the road, beat Houston in Houston. I think they beat Dallas this week. That's one of my picks. That's going to be tough. The AFC, I'll tell you this, I think the Super Bowl winner is coming out of the AFC.
I agree with you.
Either the Chargers, the Chiefs, the Patriots, or the Texans.
Yeah, that seems fair enough.
The NFC playoff picture. The Saints coming in at number one because the number two Rams just got their butts rammed up in more butts in Chicago. The Chicago Bears, who did the butt ramming,
the monsters,
are at number three. The Dallas Cowboys, who are a little bit inflated egos, have defended and miraculous plays by Amari Cooper their way into the fourth seed. They're probably going to win the NFC East. Coming in solidly at number five are the Seattle Seahawks, who we just saw on Monday night put it to the six-seeded Minnesota Vikings. Now, the NFC playoff picture, let me check some sources and tell you what that looks like. So you got Philly and Washington team from Washington who are close by, but also the New York Giants are not eliminated yet. They can still get a wild card spot. Green Bay's in there at 5-7. Detroit also at 5-8. Carolina 6-7. And Tampa Bay at 5-8. I think Tampa Bay you can pretty much count out. How do you guys see this going down?
Fellas, I'm going to tell you right away. I'm looking. I don't want anything to do with Seattle.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Right. I don't want anything to do with that team.
Right.
They've got the experience, and when they get hot, they get hot.
Mm-hmm. Seattle is a lot like San Diego in that they may be the second best team in the NFC, not just the NFC West.
Yeah.
But they're stuck behind the Rams. So I think they've got that wild card spot locked up. Minnesota seems a little bit vulnerable, but looking at the schedule of the other teams makes me feel okay for them. Plus, they've got that one in the third column. I think that's going to help them big time.
Yeah.
If you look at the Panthers, for example, they're playing the Saints two out of three times in the last three games.
Two losses.
So, yeah.
Should there be ties in football?
They're out of here.
Yeah.
Man, those ties are important. Those ties can be important towards the end of the season.
Indeed.
It's really a shame to see the Panthers, man, to see how they've collapsed because the talent on that team, especially with the youth they have and that defense, they should be doing a lot more. If they can miraculously pull off those wins at the Saints and somehow sneak into the playoffs, I'd look out for Carolina. But I don't trust the Vikings. I don't trust Kirk Cousins in any big game, any type of game that has any significance. He's not my cousin.
But looking at the last three games that these teams have, I feel like they're in the best position right now.
Right.
If they win two out of three, which they're likely to do, I think they're going to take that sixth spot.
Yeah, they can lock it up. It's going to be really interesting to see how all of this really shakes out, because I'm sure we might have an entirely different playoff picture come next week. Our next episode, we'll be out here erasing things and painting new playoff pictures for you. The playoffs are coming up, and we're very excited. Who's in and who's out? You'll find out when we do. We'll be back.
But we already know. That's why you...
Looking at the Gucci, it's about that time. Honest press conference. We have Cowboys owner Jerry Jones at the podium.
Well, howdy. How you guys doing there today? I'm feeling pretty fresh. Got a good night's rest. Put a shave on. Got a little Just for Men in the hair. So why don't we fire off on some questions?
Okay, cool. I got a question for you, Mr. Jones. This is Randy White, Dallas Gazette.
Hey, Randy.
Do you feel about your role in the organization? A lot of people say that you overstep bounds. A lot of people say that over the past few years, since you've let your son Steven make some decisions, you've actually acquired good talent. How do you feel about all the criticism about the moves you make as far as personnel?
Well, first of all, let me ask you this question. If you go to a store and buy a sandwich, do you have the right to eat that sandwich? Do you have the right to put that sandwich in the refrigerator? Can you take out the ham and insert turkey? You can do whatever you want with that sandwich. I bought and paid for it. Second of all, I am the owner, the general manager, the head coach, and a lot of people don't know this, the third string quarterback waiting for my opportunity. And you know what? The results speak for themselves. We're headed to the playoffs, baby. Next question.
All right.
All right. Mr. Jones, this is Ed Tuttle Jones from the Dallas Times.
Love the name.
So is Amari Cooper worth that first rounder?
Oh, my goodness. That might be the best decision I have ever made. I'll tell you what. Amari Cooper is a complete player. And I don't mean he plays all the different positions on the team. I mean he's got 208 bones. He's got 10 fingers, 10 toes, 32 adult teeth. That's not count the wisdom teeth. We checked. He is fully complete. Next question.
Hey, this is Danny White with the Dallas Weekly. I'm wondering, would you consider yourself eligible for Coach of the Year?
Yes, I am, as far as I know, in the running for Coach of the Year, GM of the Year, Third String Quarterback of the Year, Octogenarian of the Year, and in my own household, Man of the Year. Oh. So, you know what? I'm feeling pretty good about myself, feeling pretty good about my boys, and we're going to see what the season has in store for us. Thank you so much. Next question? Nope, no more questions. All right.
Inquiring minds will be satisfied. Honest Press Conference continues with Vance Joseph.
Hey, Vance. This is Jake the Snake with the Mile High Weekly. And I'm just wondering, have you been talking with Elway and your quarterback about what you're going to do to develop a better offense to match your defense?
You said talking. Nice. I'm sorry, what was the question? Oh, yeah, yeah. Was I hanging out with Tommy and Johnny and everybody? Okay, so yeah, this is what we did. After the game on Sunday, you know, we lost to San Francisco, and I was like, fellas, this really ain't gonna work. And Johnny was like, man, I got some stuff, let's go to the back. So we go to the back of the team facility when we fly back into town, and we're rolling it, and I'm just like, Case, man. What's good, man? You're not really holding it down. You're not sticking the paper to the glue so we can get this inside. And he was just trying to figure it out. And so we might make the playoffs. I don't know, man. You know, it's just all one big season. Next question.
Yeah, Coach Joseph. This is Steve Atwater with the Mile High One Hitter Quitter.
Oh, Steve.
So now that Emmanuel Sanders is hurt, Are you regretting trading Demaryius Thomas a little bit? Because doesn't seem like nobody can catch on your team right now.
We got a lot of rookies, man. You know what it's like when they're rookies. You give them one catch, one took, and they just pass out. they can't really hang, you know. I mean, Brandon was really, really, he was good, man. That thing would pass around 3-4 times, and every time he'd be at it, catch it, catch it smoke, catch it fire. But we had to let him go, man, because it just worked out. And maybe one of these rookies, Cortland Sutton, one of the other ones, you know, Philip Lindsay's from Colorado, so he knows how we fly, baby. Next question. All
right. Very groovy. Thanks. Yeah, Coach, this is Nick Mullen's dad just getting some notes for the family scrapbook. How did you feel about Nick Mullen's performance? Just shredding. And I mean shredding.
Oh,
that's
man.
Stout tea.
He really shredded, man. It was like Hendrix at Woodstock. He was just like, excuse me while I throw to George Kittle's touchdown. It was great, man. I mean, it was cool to watch. And then I realized he's playing for the other team. And that wasn't so cool. Like I said, it was a really strange flight home with John and everybody. And I didn't know we couldn't smoke on private planes. It's kind of wild, man. Well, next question. No more questions, dude.
What a long, strange trip. Thanks, Coach. Must have been.
Yeah, man.
Thank you.
Bring some of that stuff to.
Honest Press Conference keeps rolling along with the man, the GOAT, Tom Brady at the podium.
Hey, guys. How you doing? I'm just having some kale.
Hey,
Presser
Tom.
Time. Let's go. What do you want to talk about?
Hey, Tom, I got a question for you. This is Manny Ramirez from the Boston Globe.
Hey, man, Ram.
They say, you know, we saw that your book came out, wonderful, revolutionizing way to treat oneself with self-care and to be an excellent athlete. How does that really work for you?
Well, let me tell you, Manny, this cracks me up. This is delicious, by the way. I recommend everyone, but I see guys like Ben Roethlisberger trying to adapt my dietary regimen. You got to own this. You got to live this. It's not something you just, you know, take a bite out of and just throw away. This is something you have to dodge and dance around with. It's a dance partner. It's a dietary dance partner.
Nice. Nice.
Yeah. Next question.
Thanks. Tom, it's Drew Bledsoe, the Has-Been Weekly. Ooh. How do you feel about your chances after that upset loss? And what is the deal with your performance in Miami?
Oh, sorry, I was chewing. Hey, let me tell you something. Miami is like one of those hiccups I have every year. But the fact is, everyone knows this. Miami just cost the AFC to lose because we are now going to own the AFC because of that loss. Can you understand what I'm saying?
No clue. Thank you, though.
All right, next question.
Mr. Brady. This is Rodney Harrison of the HGH News. What was it like to play with Aaron Hernandez?
Hey, Rod Harrison, let me tell you something. You know, he was, like all my teammates, you know, a cog in a wheel. And no more questions.
Thanks, Tom. You know, these are some of my favorite moments on the ship. And all the guys are down in their bunks, Mav stuffed to the gills with pizza and cheesesteak and adult beverages. And it's just me sitting here with my diary, letting out my thoughts. Dear diary, football is crazy. And one thing that kind of makes me feel a little insecure is, I mean, is it just me or does football make you feel stupid sometimes? There's things you think are certain, and then it goes the other way. But you know who really looks stupid? These coaches going for it on 4th and 2 in the second quarter and getting stuffed. I mean, we saw Mike Vrabel fall victim to it. He tried to run that tight end who got stuffed, and then immediately the next play was a 98 or something yard touchdown. But they learned, and they showed Jacksonville what they had learned. Jacksonville went for the 4th and 2, or whatever it was, in the second quarter. And they got stuffed. And then Derrick Henry went off with that 99-yard run. How many times do we need to see it? How many times do you need to learn your lesson? Unless you're trying to win the game in the last moments, just kick the field goal. Just kick it. It's sort of like the two-point conversion. You know when you go for the two-point conversion? When you have to. My boy Kyle Shanahan knows that. He didn't see them making it 21-0 for no reason. You just kick the extra point, you kick the field goal, and you're grateful. Because otherwise what you've got is a big letdown on offense and a fired up defense. That can change momentum for minutes, quarters, maybe the entire game. So, although I might not be the smartest guy in the room, well, I probably got this room right now. I might not be the smartest football mind out there. I will tell you this. Coaches, stop making these stupid decisions. Don't give me this, I'm trying to light a fire. I trust my defense. Just take the 3 points. Your poor kicker's sitting there with nothing to do. Let him get in there. Don't you think, Mav?
Yeah, Brooke, it sounds good.
See? He knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Are we on?
I am. You're sleeping. Good night, bud.
Good night, Jim.
And good night, diary. Love, Jesse.
Get into the game with Garden Swartz Team Sales. They have everything you need, from screen printing, embroidery, and digital printing services, high school letterman jackets, and all high school and club uniforms and individual and team apparel with the most reliable brands like Speedline, Rawlings, and Wilson. And don't forget to check out the latest F7 Shut helmet. It's all at Garden Swartz Team Sales. Give them a call, 505-884-1234. Garden Swartz Team Sales.
All right, all right, all right. Checking out the standings. Rookie Jesse coming in strong, 11-5. Three-way tie for 9-7 between Ben, Mav, and myself. Friday, you came in at 500. That's not too bad. Not too bad at all. No. Season standings, Jesse extends his lead to 4 games over Benny, to 10 games over Mav. I have yet to crack the 120 club, and Friday, it's respectable, 61-40.
Hey, the Mav's not going to concede yet.
That's right. We still have plenty of games left, but you know what that means? We're passing it along. Bragging rights. Bragging rights. We got to pass it along
to
the Rook.
I want to thank all my sources and Zima. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Thank the sources. Yeah. Come on. You don't need sources when you've got a gut that tells you what's going to happen. I'll tell you what. This week, very important week for me. Like Khalil mentioned earlier, I had a 2-game lead previously over Benny. And it turned out that Ben and I picked 6 games differently. So in those 6 games, I was watching like a hawk. You want to know what 2 of them were? I'll tell you.
What were 2 of those?
Yeah, thanks for asking. One of them was the Niners over the Broncos. And I believe my prognostication, my rationale on that was, come on, you've got another win in you.
Yes.
Turns out they did.
Homer.
Woo. Not quite a homer. I did not do the research, although I intended to, but I'm quite certain that if we went back and looked over the course of my 49ers picks, for the most part, I got them. I know, no, I don't know, I think that's real. I think that's real. Like I said, didn't look at the data, but I think you guys can take my word for it on that. Come on.
Yeah.
The other pick that put me over the edge was the Bears over the Rams.
Touched by a
Friday, Ditka. Yep, I was touched by a Ditka on that one. Friday was on that train with me, and I believe there was some prognosticator, maybe perhaps it was Mav, said something like, oh, these guys have all played everywhere, and that may be true, but when you live in Chicago, it's different than visiting Chicago, all right? Jared Goff in Berkeley, first of all, the East Bay has the best weather in the entire world, if not universe. Wow. So Jared Goff is sitting pretty up there in Berkeley. And when he has to come to a place like Chicago, it's going to hurt, physically hurt, to take a breath. I spent 2 weeks in Wisconsin in December, the winter of 1999. It snowed 31 inches. I was sick within 36 hours. When it was negative 20, we brought the dog in, okay? When it was 0, we went for a walk because it was a nice day. Now, when I went back to California, only after 2 weeks, I was wearing a t-shirt in the wintertime. My friends thought I was crazy. I thought they were crazy. It makes a difference. So
Ultimately, what I'm getting at here is that I'm holding this thing for a reason. There's 3 more weeks, and if I can avoid an epic Frosty the Snowman meltdown, the likes of which Cam Newton is displaying, I think I ought to cruise to victory on this one. And some people might say beginner's luck.
On the game picks.
Yeah, okay, that's fair enough.
We'll be right back. All right, you know what time it is. It's time for our game picks to see who gets bragging rights for next week. Starting off with tonight's game, the game of the week, the Los Angeles Chargers taking on their AFC West opponent, the Kansas City Chiefs. What's happening with this one, fellas?
What a game.
This game absolutely has the makings for fireworks, and it looks spectacular, but I could not be any more disappointed that's on Thursday night. Got to go Chiefs. Short week, home team, Thursday night game. I think the scheduling kind of took the air out of the wind.
Hey, Brooks, save it for your bragging rights. I tell you what, the Chargers are hot, and Phillip Rivers is hotter than Georgia asphalt.
Ooh. I really like what the Chargers are doing this year, but no run game, I think, equals a victory for the Chiefs.
Oh, wow. I see the Chargers winning this game. They know they have to win this game to seal the division. If they win this game, if the Chargers win out, they get home field advantage in the playoffs. And I think they would like everybody to come through their little soccer stadium.
I know I'd like to play there.
And make it to the Super Bowl. Okay,
better than winning.
Guess what's happening now, guys? It's so special. Saturday football games.
Yes.
Yay! Saturdays. Awesome.
Right.
Houston taking on the New York Jets. Friday, how you feel?
You know, I love my Jets, but yeah, this is one where I need a few victories. So, Houston, come on.
There you go.
Friday, maybe not this year, because Houston should probably take the whole crown.
Yeah,
they might.
So, well, I'm going to go that route.
Yeah, agreed. Even though they're traveling all the way over there, they've got this. They're going to bounce back hard.
All right, we are going to sweep this one right on out as I see the Houston Texans bouncing back and getting a win. A hard-fought game and a good game, but they're going to get the win. Cleveland at Denver. Both teams are still in the wild card race. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this I could see this being a really fun pick for people that want to pick the Browns, but they're going a mile high. Broncos are going to bounce back and take this.
It's a good point, Rook, that mile high factor. But I'm going with the Browns because Baker, the difference maker.
Hey, I'm going to rock with the Browns short this too. Mile high, still. Hey, Browns are rolling.
I'm going to ride that Browns train as well. They're playing well, and they can taste and sniff the playoffs for the first time in what seems like eons.
Yeah,
and
leave
so
me on a limb.
The fact that they're in the playoff race in week 15 is an accomplishment in
well done,
of
Browns.
Itself. Coming up, Sunday games now. Arizona at Atlanta, fight of the birds.
Yeah.
The Falcons versus the Cardinals. Who's going
to
win?
Ugly. 7 wins between them, and the 8th one's going to the Falcons.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going with the Cardinals on that one.
All right.
Wow. I think the Falcons have some pride to play for, so.
Yeah.
Falcons.
I'm going to ride Falcons as well. They have pride to play for, and it's about time that they pull this one off. The next game, Detroit at Buffalo. Another stinker.
Yeah, the difference here just might be the travel. Detroit, despite being in Michigan, plays extremely poorly in cold weather, so let's go Bills.
You know, Rooks, probably because they have a dome.
Exactly.
So I'm going to go with Buffalo.
Yep.
Yeah, Buffalo has one of the leading rushers in the league.
Yeah.
Their quarterback.
But, yeah.
No, I think Detroit's going to bounce back. They need a win, too. They're playing for a little pride there.
Okay.
Yeah, I see Detroit winning this one. Kerryon Johnson's back, and Detroit seems to pull it off. I think Buffalo is going to make too many mistakes to win the game.
No
all right.
Either.
Yeah, exactly. Green Bay going into Soldier Field to take on that defense. Is Aaron Rodgers going to make it out alive?
Yeah, maybe not. This is a classic revenge game. And the Bears are going to put it right on them. Better team, more to play for, Bears.
Boy, I tell you what, I think this is one of those Aaron Rodgers moxie games. He's going to pull up his bootstraps and rip one out of Soldier Field.
Monsters of the Midway. They remember the little trash that Aaron talked earlier in the season.
Oh, yeah.
I think they're going to make him pay for it.
They're going to make him pay big time. Mav, you're out on your own with this one because I'm
That's
going Chicago Bears.
Perfect week for the Mav.
Oakland taking on Cincinnati.
This is a strange matchup, isn't it?
Very strange matchup. What are you thinking?
I'm going to go with Cincinnati, home field. But I don't even know why I'm talking, because this is a strange game, and it could go either way.
It definitely could. Oakland's shown some flashes. They might be believing in themselves, although they only won because the kicker slipped. I'm going Bengals.
Yeah, this is a stinker, like you said. It's tough, man. I think Oakland's going to pull it out. Even though they're tanking, I think Cincinnati's too banged up.
Yeah, Cincinnati's banged up, and John Ross and Tyler Boyd are great receivers, but they're no A.J. Green. I see Oakland winning a game on the road in this one. Dallas taking on the Indianapolis Colts.
Yeah. Ooh,
this is a tough pick.
Mm-hmm.
This is a tough pick. I went Dallas.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going Colts. I think Dallas is going to come back to earth just a little bit here, and the Colts are on fire.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think, Friday?
I'm pulling for the Colts. Baltimore is going to win, I think.
I think Dallas is going to win a close one. I think they're just rolling a little bit.
They're playing strong football right now.
And I like what the Colts are doing, but I think that defense is, and I love defense, so.
Hey, but if you love defense, quiet as it's kept, Colts have one of the better defenses in the league as well.
We haven't heard that.
We have never said that about
the
Colts.
Defensive rookie of the year with
linebacker. We've never said anything like that about the Colts in a long, long time.
That's
okay.
Where you get your facts
job,
from
Captain.
Us, folks.
Job,
the Miami Dolphins going into Minnesota to take on the Vikings.
Yeah, this is one of those games the Vikings going to win. It's one of the higher FBI percentages. I don't know. Vikings.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I don't even know what the Vikings are anymore. They have no identity as a football team. I'm going to go with Pirate Jay Cutler and the Dolphins.
Okay.
Yeah, new coordinator. I think Minnesota gets it jumping, hits the run game.
Exactly.
Minnesota this week.
Yeah, Dalvin Cook goes off, so it's a sweep. Vikings? Oh, no, you're going Dolphins.
Oh, no, I'm going Dolphins.
He's going Dolphins. We got Vikings. 1 minute left. 1 minute left. Speed round. Tennessee at New York Giants.
Giants going to pull it off at home.
G-men. Big Blue.
No, Odell, I think Tennessee might get this one.
Giants, I think the Giants win. Washington at Jacksonville.
Jacks.
Yeah. Might as well.
Sweep.
Jacksonville.
Sweep.
Washington.
Okay. Washington. Oh! Okay. Tampa Bay at Baltimore.
Baltimore going to run
Baltimore.
Through.
Baltimore.
Sweeping that out, sweep Baltimore. It. Seattle at San Francisco.
Seattle. Man, they're hot.
Sweep it.
Yeah, they're better.
Seattle.
Sweep it out. New England at Pittsburgh. Sweep this one.
New England. For New England, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Belichick owns him.
New England.
New England. Sweep.
New England.
All right. We're sweeping that one out. Philadelphia at the Rams.
Ooh.
Rams. Huge favorites, and they're going to do it.
Rams got this one.
Carson Wentz is out. We'll see Nick Foles, but Rams.
Rams as well. And the last one, New Orleans at Carolina.
Nothing could be finer than New Orleans winning in Carolina.
There you go.
Nicely done there. I thought nothing was finer than a 49er, but we'll take the Saints in this.
Okay.
What?
New Orleans.
We're sweeping this one out. All right, everybody. We want to thank you for checking out the Prognosticators. Big shout out to Gina and everybody at Paradise Vintage Clothing for providing us with wardrobe. Shout out to Benny. Benny, feel better.
Get well,
feel
brother.
Better.
Love you.
We miss you, man. Everybody, enjoy the games. Enjoy the Saturday games. We're the Prognosticators. We will be back next week. Yeah, baby.
And I'll have better bragging rights for you.
Oh, I'm getting bragging rights.